Jeva Mishe Kitoso Hidartha Jani Shudehan Taravartikeshu Gehe Shajayat Majarati Matsu No Priti Yukta Yavadartha Chaloki Jeva Mishe Kitoso Hidartha Jani Shudehan Taravartikeshu Gehe Shujayat Majarati Matsu No Priti Yukta Yavadartha Shaloke Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad when took sannyas in Chaitanya Math that day before taking sannyas Prabhupad going to take bath in Ganga. And with Prabhupada, some devotees following. In the midway, Prabhupada speaking about sannyas brato. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur speaking to those devotees, those who are following Prabhupada, while Prabhupada going to take bath in Ganges. There is two types of sannyas, specially mentioned in Bhagavatam. One is dhir sannyas, another is narottama sannyas. Prabhupada was speaking so many things about these two types of sannyas. Usually, those who are going through Gita, I already told, what is the basic thing of sannyas? I was speaking about this thing. Those who are not having any hatred for anything, any object, they are actually, or no attraction, they are actually nitya sannyas. Prabhupada speaking about dhir sannyas and narottama sannyas. Prabhupada speaking, actually, those who are inborn, having some detachment, inborn, they are having some detachment due to their previous sukriti or something. After taking bath, after some time, they gradually, they can exhibit that detachment for everything. And on time, they're living family life means not marriage life only, and father, mother, sister, they leave and go away in search of that Supreme Lord. Actually, we all taking bath this material world, we have only one and single duty. What is that? To do bhajan of Krishna. I mean, we all are in search of Krishna, directly or indirectly. We are all in search of Krishna. This is the point. So those who are going to live family life, I mean home, having strong affinity, attraction for Supreme Lord, they are growing detachment, they are actually dhir sannyas. And those who are narottam sannyas, for them actually, they are leading family life, they are doing some business or service, anything they are doing, they are attached with, they are always attached with material things, usually. After some time, the environment, I mean, situation is created such a way, so they feel it necessary to live family life, I mean home. Like in Bhagavatam, you can get example of Tridandi Bhikshu. Tridandi Bhikshu, you know. You can get Krishna Bhagavan speaking all in details about that Tridandi Bhikshu to Uddhavji Maharaj. Uddhav, you see, there was a nice Brahman, very nice man. He was doing big business all the time. But by chance, there was a big loss in his business. He is almost bankrupt. Government came, I mean king came to take over all properties, everything. And some dacoits came before to take away everything. After that, he was left with almost nothing. Then his family members, I mean wife, sisters, sons, they wanted to throw him out. Now you are useless. So long we thought that you have so many property, someday we can get. But he was very close-fisted, very kripan. Kripan means don't mind to spend money. That was his very bad quality. He never want to spend money properly for family members, for sister, daughters, wife. So naturally they are very anxious, very angry with him. So now opportunity coming, they're throwing out. Go away. We don't need you. Then he was thrown away. Then without penniless, he is traveling here and there and thinking, why this kind of situation is created in my life? All on a sudden, I don't know why. Due to adverse situation, the kind of treatment he already received from family members and for outsiders, follow, those who are servants of king and dacoits, friends, and so this way he developed tremendous detachment. And all on a sudden he could realize, so long, my age is now almost 60. So long I never think about that. My age is 60. Up to now, I was never thinking about this kind of detachment. I think today Supreme Lord is very happy with me, very satisfied with me. Why? He is very satisfied with me. That's why I am at present developing this kind of detachment inside heart, as if I need nothing. As if I am thinking that this is one kind of blessing. My wife giving bad treatment, all my daughters, on everybody, bad treatment. It's actually one kind of blessing, I think. Supreme Lord bless me today. Now, where is Pingala Vesha? Also thinking that way. Pingala Vesha, one kind of pros. As when I can discuss Bhagavatam, already I discussed. Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. There some Sukriti was there. Otherwise, how it is possible that he developed this kind of detachment all of a sudden? There it is written, Vishwanath Chakravarti was writing, the one Muni, his name is actually Ajagar Tapasi, his name, or Dattatya Muni. Dattatya Muni, one day, passing through that place, he has no attachment to anybody. If somebody giving prasadam, okay, not giving anything, okay, for a long time, like python lying, without any effort to clean body, to take bath, sleep, is written. Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking that Dattatya Muni someday passing through that place, and he was and he took place there for the night time, for night, and that time he could see that cross is so dangerous. So he was praying that she can change her heart and develop detachment. One day, one night, and that draws, requesting him, please, O Muni, please come. I can clean this place for you. You take rest. What you need, you speak. After that Muni gone, someday, very shortly, very soon, that her Lord, I mean, he was feeling detachment. Someday, from evening time to night time, whole day, sometime coming outside room, going inside room, coming out. Oh, today I can get a nice, you know, rich man to get money. Also I can enjoy. Both I can get. Whole night he is thinking about this, right from the evening up to midnight over. He is thinking, coming inside, going outside, coming inside. But by chance, he could not get any, even a single customer that day. And by the mercy of that Muni, he was developing tremendous detachment all on a sudden. He was feeling very, oh, I am so dirty. I am doing so wrong activity. So dirty activity I am doing and collecting money. What I can do with money? Anytime I can get a lot of money I am collecting, what I can do? Anytime I can die. And I am always expecting one nice hero to get association and money. But I think Supreme Lord is the topmost hero, Sri Krishna. You can remember, in Mathura Kubja, also speaking this way, your topmost hero. So I want your association. Krishna say, someday I can satisfy you, not today. This way, actually, that her Lord developed detachment, and that same day, he developed so strong detachment, leave everything. Everything. And he took decision to worship Supreme Lord to get him as his hero in his own life, in her own life. This way actually. Now actually, here actually, you see, Dhir Sannyas and Narottama Sannyas, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving example of this Narottama Sannyas, about which? About whom? That Tirandi Bhikshu. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Uddhav, you see the situation in which he is put into. So naturally he is developing detachment. He took decision, I can take sannyas, Tirandi Sannyas, and leave home forever, and my mission, what? I can lead my life in search of Krishna. From then onward, he took sannyas, he is traveling here and there, and as common people not knowing anything about his tattva, sometime doing some operation, taking away commandal, danda, taking away, sometime joking, he is a fraud actually, not sannyas. Sometime after whole day getting some collection, I mean, collection means some rice, he want to cook at the bank of some river, nice, he is cooking to offer to Krishna, and ultimately to take some prasadam somewhere, somehow he want to lead his life. In the meantime, when he is going to take prasadam, some wicked boy is coming and making urine on his pot, spitting on him. But still he not feeling any angry attitude. Guru Pad Padmo and Guru Varga used to speak, whenever you become angry, whenever you are feeling dissatisfaction, you can get the advice of Guru Varga. My son, you are angry with him, why? You should remember about the tattva of that Tirandi Sannyas. If you can think, if you can realize that tattva, immediately you can become very peaceful, humble attitude. Any kind of situation you are put into, you should think, it is one kind of testing by Supreme Lord. Why you are thinking, like Gaurgisar Babaji Maharaj, you can remember. Gaurgisar Babaji Maharaj at the bank of Ganga standing, some wicked boys, they are joking with him. Hey, you like to see the woman taking bath in Ganga? A very bad man. Ha! and throwing stone on him. Gaur-Gisar Babaji Maharaj never see anything. He is less interested about anything in this material world. He is only thinking about Supreme Lord. They are throwing stone on him. Gaur-Gisar Babaji Maharaj with the apple, speaking, not expressing any angry attitude and speaking only, "You all wicked boys, you are, you know, doing so much, putting me in problem. I can go to Yashoda Ma to lodge a complaint with her. Why you are putting me unnecessarily? What I have done?" This way, actually, Gaur-Kishore Babaji Maharaj Nitya Sannyasi. Actually, Sannyasi is a term very secret. Gradually, I like to explain this thing. Maybe previously I give one speech about this. The second, maybe third also, great big explanation. I already told sannyas, this word, grammatically if you like to split up this word, in Sanskrit, sat, sat plus nas. Sat means the absolute truth, Supreme Lord. You are going to throw himself, you are going to throw himself, sell himself to Supreme Lord. You want to sell yourself unto the lotus feet of that Supreme Lord. Your heart is not with you, now resting unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. That is called actual sannyas. With this sense, if you approach, you can find Vishnu Priya Devi is topmost sannyas. You can find Radharani is topmost sannyas. With this sense. But actually, we like to get explanation about this thing. Actually, those who are Sahajiya, those who are always against Gauriya Mat, they are fighting all the time with this issue. With this issue. Why you are taking red cloth? Why you are taking sannyas? Why you are taking a skirt that? Where it is there? They are criticizing all the time. They are giving one or two examples, I already told before. They are quoting one or two instant, and they are criticizing Gauriya Mat. Where from you get red sannyas? Where from you get sannyas? Danda, red cloth, and, you know, skirt set, where from you getting? There is nothing written there in scripture. Really so, nothing written there in scripture. That's why the topic of this discussion was, who told that red cloth and sannyas is prohibited in Gauriya society? Who told? That was the topic of that day. Today also same topic. So now they are sometime quoting one or two sloka. One is
Ashwamedham Goalambham Sannyasam Palapaitrikam Devarena Sutatpattim Kalau Pancho Vivarjayat. Ashwamedham Govalambhan Sannyasam Palapaitrikam Devarena Sutatpattim Kalau Pancho Vivarjayat. This kind of five things is prohibited in Kalikal. One is Ashwamedh Yajna, Gomedh Sannyas, and to arrange Shraddha of father by meat, and to get baby by the help of brother-in-law, Devarena Sutatpatim. Devarena Sutatpatim Kalu Pancho Vivarjaya. This all three are prohibited in Kalikal. You cannot do. It's very
these five kind of things totally prohibited in Kalu Pancho Vivarjayat. Is totally vivid. And they also quoting some useless instant, they don't know. They are actually Guru Varga speaking, Prabhupada speaking. We think they never situated in Srauta Pantha. We think they are never situated in Srauta Pantha. That's why they are making some ugly meaning of those sloka. What is another sloka? This quote from Chaitanya Charitamrita. When Sanatana Goswami is speaking, Rakta Vastro Vaishnavir Paritana Jivai. Red cloth, one Vaishnav should not wear red cloth. Sanatana Goswami is speaking. Now, usually they are quoting one or two sloka like this, nothing else. After that, they start criticizing about Chaitanya Sannyas, this, that. What do you mean by Chaitanya Sannyas? I already told. Kai, man, bakya. Speech, body and mind. If you are going to give punishment, you are going to get punishment, na? Kai, man, bakya. Three kind of punishment. So you can never feel agitated. You can never feel agitated. So, kai man bhakya. Kai man bhakya means any jivatma doing any aparad or any punya karma they are doing by kai man bhakya. Three. That's why Jamduta, Ajamil, looking, three Jamduta coming. Whereas four Narayan Duta are coming to protect. Narayana. Four Narayan. And Vaikuntha Parshad coming. So Kai, Man, Bhakya, body, speech and mind, anytime, bonded soul, those who are not Siddha. Siddha means totally established in his bhajan. Preliminary Siddha means out of the influence of Maya. Prakriti, a preliminary. After that, if you are established in Nam bhajan and feel everything there in Golokdham, then you are perfect Siddha. But you can remember, Rupa Goswami Pad always speaking, even if you are growing the quality to meet with Brahma Sakshatkar, Brahma means not Nirvishesh Brahma, Savishesh Brahma also. Maybe you have the quality to meet with Paramatma or Gyanishtha, feel everything, Gyanashiddha. Still that time, if you have some Parabdha, you have to cut your Parabdha yourself through your activities. Yad brahma sakshad kritinishthayapi vinasamayati vinana bhogai apaiti namus puranena tatte parabdha karmeti virauti vedaha. It is the Rupa Goswami Pad. Still you will have to cut. But when Harinam can exhibit everything you can realize through Harinam, then no problem. Even Krishna Bhagavan speaking that Gyananishto Viraktova Madhavaktova Anapekshakaha Sa Linganam Ashramam Stakta Charit Avidhi Gocharaha. They are bound in the rules and regulations. Who? Gyananishto. There is a Pakagani. Pakagani means? The right definition of Pakagani is that he is Bhakta. Pakagani means he can never feel any hatred for anything, any attraction. And at the same time, I would say those who are Pakagani, how they become Pakagani? Why they are not feeling any attraction for anything? They are looking everything Shamadishti. How is possible? Actually, Sanatana Goswami is speaking, it is only possible when they are getting Pakka Gyan. Self-realized there now. They can feel their equal side. That means surely they are getting some prema. Otherwise, not possible. Pakka Gyani means Gyananishto means Pakka Gyani. And bhakta, whom you can speak bhakta? Whom you can say that he is devotee, Vaishnava? Whom? As per the definition of Shastra? Parikshit Maharaj Vaishnava, Ambarish Maharaj Vaishnava, Pritsu Maharaj Vaishnava, Devan Vaishnava, Yudhishthira Maharaj Vaishnava, everything they are put into all surrounding. Oh, so much property. So what? Nothing touching their heart. Follow? They are developing prema for Krishna, for everybody. Either way, tell them. So, Sanatana Goswami is speaking. Until and unless they are getting some prema, it is not possible to have equal sight. Because if you can see whole world in relation to Krishna, then and only then I can say you are Pakka Vaishnava. Follow you. Then you are Vaishnava. So those who are sahaja, they are going to attract Gauranga. Hey, where is written? Sanatana Goswami actually speaking, Rakta Vastra Vaishnaver Paritana Juvai. Idiot number one. They are so ignorant. They have no idea about scriptural analysis. Sometimes they can memorize something, but I think they should be thrown out of Vaishnava society. They are making some garbage. In Radha Kunda here, they are making some garbage. So foolish. What is the meaning? What you are speaking, you know? What do you mean to say? Rakta Vastra Vaishnaver Paritana Chuvai. Can you analytically try to understand this situation? What was the situation in which Sanatana Goswami was bound to speak that way? Foolish number one. Baba Maharaj, one day, very nice instant. Jagadananda Pandit already gone to Vrindavan. MahaPrabhu giving warning, Jagadananda, be careful. Whenever you are going to Vrindavan, you must stay all the time with Sanatan. Not even fraction of second, you cannot keep yourself away from Sanatan. Be continuous in touch with Sanatan. What is the meaning? What is the inner meaning? How you know? You can buy volumes of book and show me the meaning. You go through books. You can read books without Kripa of Guru Vaishnava. You can go through books and show me what is the meaning. What do you mean by that? Why MahaPrabhu speaking, Jagadananda, try to stay with Sanatana all the time, not even fraction of a second. Get detached from him. What is the meaning? Sanatana Goswami is Sammandagan Acharya, MahaPrabhu giving indication, giving warning to us. You should always get in touch with Sammandagan Acharya all the time. All the time. The moment you lose your attachment, you can fall down, you can develop different. You can develop different kind of desire. Oh, Maharaj, I need it. I am so bad situation. Why you are not satisfied? Because you are not doing proper bhajan. The day you can get the taste of actual bhajan, nectar, you can remember I told you. Huh? In Allahabad, to Rupa Goswami, MahaPrabhu speaking, Rup, I like to give you a taste of that. Exclusive love, eva, prema. Open your mouth. Huh? Get your tongue outside. I like to give you a taste of that nectar. One drop. Krishna is the ocean of love. Krishna is the ocean of, you know, nectar. But you cannot feel. That is the main problem. Krishna is the ocean of nectar, Sanatan. Unending. I Rupa Goswami Patru. Unending ocean of nectar. I like to give you one taste. You can remember Sanatana Goswami, Tirobab Tithi, I was speaking. Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam prayatnai rapaya yatmam anabhishyamandyam kipam mudir kipam mudiriya paradukcha dukhi Tvam Svanatanam Prabhum Asrayami. Who speaking? Prayojan Gyan Acharya Raghunath Das Goswami. Be careful. Who speaking? Raghunath Das Goswami, crying and speaking. When Sanatan gone from this material world, is crying and speaking this way. Follow? So this way actually you should remember that Sambandha Gyan Acharya is Sanatana Goswami, Abhidya Gyan Acharya is Rupa Goswami Pad, and Prayojan Gyan Acharya is Raghunath Das Goswami. Now if we are detached from Sambandha Gyan Acharya, means Sambandha Gyan itself, then we can go away in the flood of Maya. Miche mayar bose jaccho bheshe khaccho habu dubu bhai. You can remember this kirtan. Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami used to speak, dance. Miche mayar bose jaccho bheshe khaccho habu dubu bhai. You understand? What is the meaning? Never gone through this kirtan. No time, Maharaj. Eh? Right from 2:30, 3 o'clock, you should start bhajan. Follow. Unnecessarily, you are going away in the current of Maya. It's one kind of Maya. It's one kind of Maya. One or different kind of Maya coming in front of us. Sometime in the form of money, sometime in the form of pratishtha, sometime in the form of nice, beautiful girl, woman. This kind of Maya coming. In front of Krishna, in front of Uddhava, Krishna speaking, so many things. Also, in front of Devahuti Ma, Kapil Muni speaking, Manuputri, mother, my Maya is so strong, nobody can stand with challenge. If you put challenge, you are number one. You are the first number to go away in the current of mind. Never try to put challenge. That's the first point. Never try to throw challenge, put challenge in front of Maya. If you the day you put challenge, be sure you are the first number to go away in Maya. On the contrary, you should express humble attitude. Oh Prabhu, your Maya is so strong. We cannot stand in Maya. Mame boje prapadante Maya metam tarantite. It is an advice of Krishna. Mam eva, affirmative, eva. Know it for sure. Mam eva je prapadante. Maya metam. Etam Maya tarantite. Te janaha taranti Maya. Jehi janaha. Surrendered unto my lotus feet. And our other people, for them there is no guarantee. So it is there, you never try to put challenge in front of Maya. On the contrary, Mahaprabhu showing us the easiest way. Mahaprabhu showing us the easiest way. But we are not ready to accept it. What is that easiest way? What is that easiest way? What is that easiest way? Trinada Vishnu Chanatara Vasishtham. Humbler than the blood. Oh Maya, you can kick me anything, but I'm very afraid. Never try to put challenge in front of Maya. Up to now, infinite effort, nobody can come out successful. Only Mame Vaje Prapadante Maya Metam Tarantite. So now actually, point is that Sanatan Goswami is the topmost acharya, you know. You can remember, in front of Jagadananda Mahaprabhu point out, he is tattvabid. In Purushottam Dham, when Jagadananda Pandit wanted to give some advice to Sanatan, Sanatan discusses something, what to do, is my this kind of skin disease developed. At the same time, Mahaprabhu gave me order to stay in Vrindavan. What to do now? This kind of Mahaprabhu coming and embracing me. Jagadanda giving advice, better you go away from this place and go to Vrindavan, because Mahaprabhu already gives selected press for you all. Oh, really? You are speaking. After Rath Yatra, I can start for Vrindavan. In the Mahaprabhu Antaryami, super soul. Mahaprabhu coming away and giving a threat in front of Jagadanda. How dare you give advice to Sanatan? He is so much Tattva Gyani, he is giving advice to me. You are giving advice to him? Huh? Mahaprabhu knowing everything. I'm heavily speaking. How dare you speak that way? Sanatan can give advice to me also. You are giving advice to Sanatan? Foolish? Then Sanatan Goswami laughing. Prabhu, now I know. You love Jagadananda so much. You are showing external honor to me. No, no, not that. Don't think that way. Actually, Marjada Longhan Mui Shaitana Bhavi. You have one dignity. He is going to break that dignity. I cannot tolerate. That Sanatan about whom you are going to pass bad remark. That sannyas and red cloth is prohibited by Sanatan Goswami. You are so number one foolish. Who? Where is that Sahaja? Staying here and there, Radha Kundo, making some garbage? They can come and try to understand this point. It is written, what was the sequence? Why Sanatan Goswami was bound to speak that way? What was the sequence? But one day, when Sanatan Goswami make one turban of one red cloth, of Mukunda Saraswati, one Mayavadi. He gave one cloth of Mukunda Saraswati and making one turban, a head, and coming in front of Jagadananda to see the kind of love he is having inside her, to test. Jagadananda meantime cooking rice on a pot. Jagadananda, whenever look at that red cloth, it become full of ecstasy, love. Oof, he can remember instantly Mahaprabhu. Because he is habituated to see the red cloth of Mahaprabhu all the time. He is staying there. Shankar Pandit, Jagadananda staying there. Govinda, there all the time. Ramai, Nandai, they speak, staying there to help, to serve Mahaprabhu all the time, at the time of sannyas in Gambira. So heavy chest, whenever see red cloth, is very full of prema. Hey, whose cloth is this? Actually, this is a cloth of Sankara. Hey, actually, Mukunda Saraswati! He becomes so angry, he take the pot of rice and wanted to throw on Sanatan. Sanatan running away. You are number one, topmost parsad of Mahaprabhu. I thought you are using red cloth of Mahaprabhu. You are using the red cloth of one Mahavadi Sannyasi, Mukunda Sasti. I cannot tolerate it. Wanted to throw red. Wanted to throw hot rice pot on Sanatan. Sanatan Rangi. Sanatan going away long and laughing. The reason for why I was acting that way. Now I am sure about that, what kind of pure love you have inside your heart for Mahaprabhu. Now I know. Oh, as soon as you see red cloth on my head, you become full of prema. So our Guru Varga give me explanation. Sanatan Goswami is speaking. Actually you are right. Raktavasta Vaishnaver Puritena Juhai. Now those Sahajya, I have an application to them. But now you point out where you find that Jagadananda Pandit having strong detachment or Sanatan Goswami having strong, you know, detachment or I mean hatred for red cloth. Where you find? With what mood Jagadananda Pandit is speaking? Jagadananda speaking that you are number one parshad. The topmost parsad of Mahaprabhu, I cannot tolerate if you use a red cloth of some other sannyasis, Mayavadis. That was the only reason. It is also the expression of deep love. It is also expression of deep love. As soon as he see red cloth, Mukundama, what is that? Rupa Goswami Pad, right? Mukunda Stotram, they are also speaking. Nice loka. I in sannyas, this grantha books I write already 10 years almost back. I can show you some document from here also. Now I'm explaining. That was the sequence. And why Sanatana Goswami is speaking that way? That Raktavasa, red clothes, sannyasi should not wear red clothes. What was the sequence? Sanatana Goswami writing so many books, he is the topmost Tattvagyan Acharya. How we can expect the Sanatana Goswami having some hatred for red clothes? Whereas MahaPrabhu taking sannyas, all other, you know, Madhavendra Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, who not? Everybody. They are all everybody, sannyas. All you can show. It not only that, all follow four acharyas from four sampradayas, they are also exhibiting sannyas. They are also exhibiting Ramanujacharya, who not? Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarkacharya, they are all sannyas. Where from you get this kind of Siddhanta, ho Sahajya? Where from you get this kind of Siddhanta that sannyas is not allowed? Four authentic Acharya, those are compiling all different Shastra, giving note, Tattva Siddhanta, Vibriti, explanation. You are pointing out they are also Sahajya? Even in Mahabharata, even in Bhagavat, even in Gita also, you can get indication of sannyas. You can get Bhagavatam also, Tirandi sannyas. Sometimes you can find Ekdandi sannyas, but our Guru or Prabhupada explaining Bhaktivinoda Thakur, though sometime before you can say, see, some acharyas taking Ekdanda sannyas, but be sure they conceive, not conceive, they feel 100% that Tridanda is present there in Ekdanda. They are not like Mayavadi. Follow this secret Siddhanta. Some of our Guru Varga you can find long ago. They are taking Ekdanda, yes. But in Ekdanda, they are feeling 100% that Tridanda is there. Be sure. They are getting this kind of indication. So everywhere in Bhagavatam also you can get, in Bhagavatam also you can get the indication of Tridandi sannyas. In Mahabharata also, everywhere, where not. In Upanishad also, different places you can get indication of Tridandi sannyas. Sannyas is more popular. Even in Bhavartha Dipika, Bhavartha Dipika, who has written Bhavartha Dipika? Who has written Bhavartha Dipika? I don't know. Siddha Samipad. Siddha Samipad giving commentary of Gita and Bhagavatam. In Bhagavatam commentary Bhavartha Dipika. About sannyas, Siddha Samipad. About Siddha Samipad, all our Guru Varga passing remark. Siddharam Betti Nishinga Prasadat. Why Siddhar Goswami, knowing all Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Bhagavatam, all at a glance, he can say everything clearly. How is that possible? Siddhar Goswami Pad knowing everything? Yes. It is written that Siddharam Betti Nishinga Prasadat, by the mercy of Nishingadev, directly, Nishingadev blessing, directly in Bhadrak, one place, in hilly place, you can go and watch that place. We have a long time Siddha Samipad doing bhajan. And Nishingadev appear in the room. After that blessing. That's why it is written, Siddharam Betti Nishinga Prasadat. By the mercy of Nishingadev, Siddha Samipad knowing everything, everything. That's why when Vallabh Acharya wanted to show some extraordinary, you know, capacity in front of Mahaprabhu, I cannot accept the commentary of Siddha Swami Pad. I have written new commentary, you can see. Mahaprabhu became very angry. What? What do you mean to say? What do you mean to say? Siddha Swami Pad is topmost. In all Vaishnava society, by the mercy of Nishingadeva speaking, how dare you are going to violate him, ignore him? Maryada langhan mui shaitana pari. I cannot tolerate if you are going to break the dignity of others. Don't speak that way. If you at all try to write something, you must write under the guidance of Siddha Swami. Go! I don't like to see. Vallabha Acharya become frightened. Ah, Prabhu become so angry. Yes. Prabhu become so angry. Mahaprabhu cannot tolerate. Maryada langan, if you want to break the dignity, Mahaprabhu cannot tolerate. That is the main thing. That Mahaprabhu took sannyas, who already told before taking sannyas, apani achari dharmo jivare sikham. Apani na achari dharmo sikhana na jai. I am going to show, exhibit, I am going to act accordingly, so that people can learn from me. That Mahaprabhu took sannyas, be careful before passing any dirty remarks. That Mahaprabhu took sannyas and you are passing that bad remark that sannyas is not allowed there. You are speaking that way. Whereas Mahaprabhu is speaking, I can act accordingly, so then all common people can see. Those who are topmost people, who are following, judges, sesto, ebetaro, yanaha, then common people following them. Those who are important people in the society, they are following, common people can follow them. So, Sanatan Goswami can never insult Mahaprabhu and all important persons, all main persons of Mahaprabhu, they are all sannyas. Brahmananda Bharati, Keshav Bharati, Ishar Puripad, Madhavanda Puripad, Who not? Everybody, they are all sannyas. Whereas Sanatana Goswami is topmost Tattva Gyan Acharya. How it is possible for Sanatana Goswami to criticize, to pass this kind of remark that sannyasis, they should not, those who are Vaishnava, they should not take sannyas. How it is possible? Whereas Prabhudananda Saraswati Bad also didn't sannyas. Kupal Bhattu Goswami also taking diksha and sannyas under his guidance. Gopal Bhattu Goswami in his Sanskrit Deepika, you can find there is written all rules and regulations of sannyas. How you are passing this kind of remark? So much ignorance. You think sannyas means no Vaishnava? What do you mean to say? Those who are sahaya, it is my question to you. What do you mean to say? That those who are sannyas, they are not, they are not actually Vaishnava? What do you mean by Vaishnava? What do you mean by Vaishnava? Hey, be careful! What do you mean by sannyas? What do you mean by bhakta? They are actually devotee, those who are developing love, strong love for Supreme. Even they are king, but still they are more detached, having so much detachment than you. What do you think? Parikhit Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Pitu Maharaj, Dhubo Maharaj, Pallad Maharaj, they are king. I love. So what is the symptom of devotee? You think the symptom of devotee is not sannyas or with sannyas? What do you mean to say? What do you mean by sannyas? Inner meaning of sannyas I already told. Now Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. All the parshad, Our Guru Bhargava speaking, all the parshads of MahaPrabhu, they are most of them the sannyas. They are having tremendous love for Supreme Lord. They are sannyas externally. Externally they are sannyas. Internally they are having Paramahansa Vrata. You can remember, just 40 minutes ago I speak this sloka. Jnananishtha virakto va madbhakto va anapekshakaha salinganam asraman stakta charit charit vidilingo charit abhidigochara. What Krishna mean to say? What is the commentary of Vishwanatha Chakravartivad about this sloka? Actually, what Krishna mean to say? Those who are paramahansa, even paramahansa, Vaishnava paramahansa, even externally you can find they are, you know, pakka gyani, jnananishtha, viraktova. For them also, red cloth and sannyas is not 100% necessary. They can take, cannot take. Why can take? Can take, cannot take. All the same for them. Why? Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, charev abhidhi gochara. They can throw everything. Or linga, I mean, symptom, chinna, and ashram. They can throw everything. They can travel like paramahansa. Is allowed for them. Now point is that those are having tremendous love for Krishna, tremendous love for Mahaprabhu. Still, if they are maintaining sannyasi like Prabhupada Saraswati Pad, Gopal Bhattu Goswami, Madhavendu Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, who not? For them you should think that way, that Maharaj, they never try to break the rules and regulations shown by Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is some so Supreme Lord taken sannyas. So they thought it necessary, Mahaprabhu sannyas, Supreme Lord. So we should show ourselves as if that we are confined within this Chatur Varna and Ashram. Chatur Varna Maya Sastam Gunakarma Vibhagasaha. They wanted to exhibit themselves. Or still today, if there is such qualified sannyasi, they want to exhibit themselves that we are not qualified. We are actually sannyas. I mean, chaturvarna, chaturvarna, and chaturasram. We are. At the same time, inside their heart, trinadapi and paramahansa bhava. Is it good or bad? Is it good or bad? Is it good or bad? Huh? It's more appreciable that you are developing total love. And paramahansa vrata inside, externally, due to dainya, humbleness. See, I am not qualified. I am sannyas, you see, within this chatur varna ashram. Ashram means topmost is sannyas. Siddha Samipad writing, pujyatamam sannyas. Sannyas ashramam pujyatamam. Sannyasam pujyatamam. Siddha Samipad speaking, topmost honor. Those actual sannyasis, they should get topmost honor. Honor, it is written by Siddha Samipad. Siddha Samipad also, sannyas. Pujyatamam, sannyasam pujyatamam. Topmost honor, they can accept. Even it is written in Shastra, any time, even your son taking sannyas, if father coming in front of son, then you have to pay prostrate at Dandavata sannyas. If not doing, then you have to go for expiation, prayaschitta guttar. So strong rules and regulations. Now, how you, big writer, they are writing volumes of book. If I want to mention their name, they can file one case against me. I can show you their writing. Sannyas is not allowed in Vaisa. They are writing these volumes of book rewriting. Follow? About Pokasananda Pobodhanu Saja, Haridas Baba. Who, my God, I like to die. Haridas Babaji Maha, who is writing Vaishnava Vidhan. He is writing Pokasananda Pobodhanu, same thing. How possible? Sunananda Vidyavinu writing. Puridas, that Ananta Vasudev, who lived Prabhupada, They are writing this way. Follow. How is possible? Maya, Maya, Maya. Is the topmost illusion of so much educated, highly qualified. They are passing this kind of due to aparadha. Prabhupada speaking, they cannot anyhow. Anyhow, they have no capacity, they can never prove. That Prakasananda, Bodhananda, same thing. Who can prove? Try to put, come. Show. Historically, physically, no, no way. Tattva Siddhanta, no way. Only those sahajiyas staying in Radhakunda, they're speaking. Their acharya speaking, their acharya. One slok they are quoting. Bhagavatam Saraswati was speaking, Mayavada Santapto, I am going to leave. Sometimes those who are topmost sannyasis, topmost devotees, they are expressing this kind of expression, humble attitude. On the basis of this sloka, they are speaking, you see, he is speaking, I was Mayavadi before, now I leave. But they cannot prove historically. I already told you. Many times, who is Prakasananda Bodhananda, these topics I discuss. They cannot prove. But first of all, when MahaPrabhu took sannyas, went to south. That time, while coming back, they meet Prabhupadananda Saraswati Bhatt, Gopal Bhatto there, Venkat Bhatto, Tirumalda Bhatto that time. How it is possible that he was already Vaishnava sannyasi from Sri Sampadaya? How it is possible after getting the association of Mahaprabhu, going again to Varanasi to take Mayavad sannyas? How is possible? Is possible? But they are speaking that way. They are so foolish. After that Mahaprabhu, long after Mahaprabhu going to Vrindavan, in the way of Vrindavan, meet Prakasananda. Whereas Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj are speaking, that not at all possible. That Prakasananda, Prakasananda same. Prakasananda Saraswati Pad, developing leprosy, white leprosy is written. Vrindavanda, nobody going through scriptural analysis under the guidance of Guru Vishnu. All puffed up. Never. You are not in Sautra Pantha. That's why you cannot understand. Otherwise you can easily trace out. Vrindavanda Thakur Maharaj is speaking. Prakasananda developing leprosy, white leprosy. Whereas Prabhupadananda, big. Up to the last moment, his life is staying in Kamban, writing so much sweet writing. Nobody can compare with his writing, so nice. Mahaprabhu himself speaking, Kashite Paraye Beta Mayavad. Prakasananda, Sei Beta Kore Mor Ongo Khando Khando, Sarmange Janmailu Kushto, in whole body I create white leprosy, still is not getting knowledge, still today, not getting consciousness. Mahaprabhu speaking in Gaura Lila, how you can pass this kind of dream? Gaura Lila, Mahaprabhu, long ago. So foolish there, they think we are, you know, Pandit, big Vidwan. They are writing this way. Sundanando, Haridas, they are writing. How we can prove? How? They are writing in Radhakunda, Anantadas. They are also writing. Anantabasudev also. All writing this way. But they cannot prove. They are giving some argument. But they cannot prove. Not possible. Follow what I say. Long after when Mahaprabhu grew up, took sannyas, after the first gone to South India, after long gapping, Mahaprabhu going to Vrindavan, that time they meet. How is possible? This is Vaishnava taking nectarian, you know, feeling. With the association of Mahaprabhu, all changed. After that he gone to Varanasi again to take Mayavad, he has gone mad? He foolish? How possible? This way they cannot prove it. And sannyas, about sannyas, you see, Mahaprabhu, all his parshad, Prakasananda, Bhagavatananda, Madhavendu, everybody sannyas. It is not the motive of Sanatana Goswami to pass this kind of remark, to criticize red cloth and sannyas in Gaudiya society. Not that. Actually, Vaishnava means having strong affinity for Supreme Lord. Quite naturally, he is developing detachment for material thing. But Krishna sambandha, anything related to Krishna, suppose some money related to Krishna, some my position related to Krishna, that is second given. It's called Jukta Vairagya. It's called Jukta Vairagya, balanced Vairagya. That is called Jukta Vairagya. Jukta Vairagya is the most valuable thing. Even it will take thousands of lives for you to realize this thing. It's very typical. That's why that day I was explaining, na? Vaishnavi Patishtha, Tate Karanishtha, Tahana Kulide Rohiva Rourav. So inside, Ambarish Maharaj, Pithu Maharaj, Parikhit Maharaj, they're all feeling detachment. They're sannyas inside. So, Sanatana Goswami want to speak this way. Vishwanath Chakravarti Vyas also, they suppose it is written there that Sanatana Goswami already told the Rakta Bhakta Vaishnaver Paritana Juhai, the only reason behind it, those who are not qualified, they, if unnecessarily taking paramahansa, is not allowed. Follow what I mean to say. They are not at all qualified. But still they want to take whites. You see, the case of Sanatana Goswami, I already told you. Sanatana, so humble, so humble. Humbler than the blade of grass. When Chandrasekhar Acharya is speaking, I like to give you a new cloth. No. If you can give me one old cloth, I can. Then after that, Sanatana Goswami accepting one old cloth, dhoti, old cloth, without any border, of course. After that, cut that dhoti into three pieces. One kopin, one uttariya, one bahirvasa. That day I already told, they are sahaj paramahansa. They inborn their paramahansa. Inborn. Who can give paramahansa to them? Who can give paramahansa to them? It is approved by Mahaprabhu. Because in front of Mahaprabhu, Sanatana Goswami take this vest and come in front of Mahaprabhu. What do you mean? You try to feel. Mahaprabhu, in front of Mahaprabhu, Sanatana, put on this cloth, kopin bahirva, and come in front of Mahaprabhu laughing. That means it is approved by Mahaprabhu. Then how you can pass this kind of remark? Where from they took paramahansa? Foolish number one. They are naturally paramahansa, sahaj paramahansa. They need not take any paramahansa. They are naturally paramahansa. Then you are passing this kind of remark. Follow? Big writer, they are writing all opposite. Where is Ras? Balaram Ras is not approved in Shastra. Oh my God! They are writer, big writer. You come to me, I can show you. If you want to express, I can give you a Xerox copy, you can give in internet. They are passing this kind of. Balaram Das is not approved in Shastra, idiot number one. Who told you? Who told you Balaram Das is not approved in Shastra? Balaram Das is approved in, not approved in, who told you? Bindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya, in first chapter you can see, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya writing. That in Shastra there is not approval of Balaram Das. Who told you? Vrindavan Das Thakur, they are pasanda. They are busy with heroic activities. Bad activities. They are not knowing any Siddhanta. They are passing this kind of radar. Who told there is Ras in Baldev? In Bhagavatam it is written. It is in Bhagavatam, it is Siddha Sami Bhad giving commentary, Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhad. Who are you to pass this kind of rima? By everybody writing their books. They are writing this kind of book. that Baldev Rasa is not approved in Shastra. Everybody buying their book, reading. Radha Govindanath. You open the book and show you the writing. No Rasa. Prabhupada, Bhagavan, same thing, they are passing. No sannyas is there, they are writing this kind of remark. Everybody writing their book. Everybody writing their book. This way. So sannyas is not allowed in Gaudiya's Vaishnava society. Sanatana Goswami want to speak this way? Do you think? Huh? Do you think Sanatana Goswami going to pass this kind of remark? That Tidandi sannyas and you know sannyas bhutto is not approved. Whereas MahaPrabhu speaking, apani achari dharmade. Be careful. Don't come in Harikatha. Don't come in Harikatha. Don't come. Follow what I say. Whereas MahaPrabhu apani achari dharma jibere sikhai. MahaPrabhu is a teacher, international teacher, all over the Brahmanda. Whereas Sanatana Goswami is going to disrespect, dishonor for sannyas bhutvan, how possible you are passing this kind of remark? That's not possible. See. So everywhere it is approved. Tidandi sannyas. Everywhere it is approved. I can show you from in this book also different from different kind from different scriptures I can show you the evidence. Everywhere it is written. Everywhere. So I can show you an example here, from here. Be careful. Everyone, actually, Madhavendu Puribad, Ishwar Puribad, Paramanda Puri, Keshav Bharati, see, Brahma, point out this point. Brahmananda Puri, Brahmananda Bharati, Vishnu Puri, Keshav Puri, Krishnananda Puri, Sri Nishinga, Nishinga Tirtho, Sri Sukhananda, everybody, they are full of love. Krishna Prema, are full of Krishna Prema. At the same time, they are having red cloth, I mean sannyas brata. Also, you can remember, MahaPrabhu before taking sannyas, after taking sannyas, passing this kind of remark. What remark? Paratma nishthamasto bezgohon, mukundo sevai hai shangshattaron. MahaPrabhu passing this remark. Very vital. People think, sannyas means he can get Krishna. MahaPrabhu never wanted to speak this way. Paratmo nishthamatto bezgohon. To exhibit strong affinity for Supreme Lord, Paratmo nishtha, they want to see that don't disturb us, we are actually in renounced order. Sannyasi, red cloth. That is the main thing. Paratmo nishthamatto bezgohon, MahaPrabhu speaking, mukundo sevaya shangshattharan. If people can pass this kind of remark, those who are not having any Siddhanta again, the sannyas means he can go to Supreme Lord. No! Not that. MahaPrabhu never wanted to speak that way. MahaPrabhu wanted to speak, MahaPrabhu speaking, Paratmu Nishtha Matsa Besgohan. If you at all like to take red cloth, first of all you will have to prove they have strong affinity for Supreme Lord. Then Prabhupada can give sannyas. Now at present, any acharya give any sannyas to anybody. What it concern to us? We are not going to fight with this point. What Prabhupada wanted to speak, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. That is main thing. That is main thing. Follow what is it? Paratma nishtha matto bes gohon. So to show strong affinity for Supreme Lord, love, you can take sannyas. Not that sannyas means you can cut material bondage and go to Supreme Lord. Not that. The second point is most vital. What is the second point? MahaPrabhu wanted to speak, Mukunda Seva Hoy Shangshattaram. Mukunda Seva means Krishna, Krishna Seva. If you want to cut material bondage and go to the Supreme Lord, that vital point is there, Mukunda Seva Hai. That is the second point is most vital than the first point. You are taking sannyas, not serving Krishna. Want to take service himself. Oh, you serve me, I am sannyas. Oh, this way. You are Ravan. You yourself cannot go out of Maya. What to speak about others, those who are following you? Excuse me. If you kill me, still I can speak this way. Who concerned? Who is taking sannyas from where? We want to speak about all Tattva Siddhanta, without which all society going in hell. Those who are following you are taking sannyas, you are giving sannyas to other, you have material bondage yourself, that time you cannot prove that you are sannyas. Prabhupad speaking, those who are all the 24 hours, those who are busy with Krishna Seva, they can become sannyas. They can become acharya. In the life of one acharya, if you find he is not at all busy with Krishna Seva all the time, he has some gapping. 4 hours he is serving, and 8 hours he is enjoying. It's not acharya. It is a remark of Prabhupada. Those who can prove 100% that all the 24 hours he is busy with Krishna Seva, this is a remarkable point you should follow in the life of one successful acharya. They can prove that we are always busy with Krishna Seva, not busy with Maya. Prabhupada speaking, only and only they can say that we are acharya. They can. Oh, of course, they are not going to deserve that we are not alive. We are fallen soul. They can speak this way because naturally they have humble attitude. Follow this point. So, Mukunda Seva Hai Shangsha Taran, that is most vital point. And the vital point you are going to ignore and establish some other useless point. This way, sannyas 100% approved in Shastra. And all the different big acharyas, they are all taking sannyas. Brata. So this way actually, Rupa Goswami Pada also writing in Mukunda Stotram. Mukunda Stotram, one sloka, very nice. I can discuss this point next day, if time permit. Rupa Goswami Pada writing was nice sloka. There speaking, that it golden, I mean that, Pita Vastra, with that red cloth, exhibiting is a sloka, is there. I can discuss next day, not today, no time. Rupa Goswami Pada writing, that it seems, we can remember, at the same time you see Pita Varan and red cloth, we can remember the glance of MahaPrabhu. So many, even Prabhupadananda also writing, so many sloka. Whenever those who are full of Gaura Prema, whenever they get, what a glance, they get red cloth, oh, they develop Prema. Like Madhavendra Puripat, as soon as looking at cloud, dense cloud, get faint. Because, can remember the complexion of Krishna. So much love. We are busy with material thing. We are busy with material thing. We are always busy with material thing. We want to discover ourselves in the midst of all painful ocean. Why? Because we are not doing Krishna Bhajan properly. We are not doing Krishna Bhajan properly, so that's why so much contradiction, confliction. If we can do Krishna Bhajan, all problems solved. No problem. In family life, you should follow your own duty. In family life, you should follow your own duty. If you are going to lead a hotel life, then I have nothing to speak. This way, I can show you one day by day that sannyas brato, And the red cloth approved in Gauriya Vaishnava society, nobody can disprove it. I challenge. Nobody can. They can fight. They can bark like dog. They cannot prove. Follow this way. The sloka I started with, I like to explain this sloka. After that, I like to finish today because time cannot permit. What sloka I started with? Jeva maishe kita sauhidartha janeshu dehantarabhartikeshu geheshu yayatma yarati matsu na prit yukta javadarthascha loke. It is about Priyabhata. In Pancham Skanda, fifth Skanda. No, actually, Jeva, not Priyabrata, more. Priyabrata is fifth Kanda, first canto. After that, you can go to Rishabdev. In front of 100 son, Rishabdev speaking. Jeva maishe kita sauhidartha jani shudehantarabhartikeshu geheshu yayatma jarati matsu na priti yuktva javadarthas chaloke. Rishabda speaking. Je ba mui ishe kirto sauhidartha. Kirto madhi already done. Those who are already getting strong love for me. Mui ishe. Mui mean I myself, Supreme Lord. For me, those who are exhibiting strong love. For them, this material, anything in this material world is not attractive for them. Jeva mai shekito sauhidartha janeshu dehantarabhartikeshu. They are not going to gossip with outside people on some political topics or some cricket game. No. Now sannyasis, they are going to watch cricket game. Yes. What is the game? What is the result? This is that. We are busy with material searching. We are not busy with, we are not in search of Krishna. Excuse me. One day one big acharya, noontime, I cannot speak name, otherwise this society can think I am criticizing them. That Maharaj, I speak jaikara of that Maharaj. He is speaking noontime, coming outside, where all the devotees were gone. His sevak saying, Maharaj, what to speak? They all gone to watch cricket game. Cricket game? All sannyasis there? They all gone for watching cricket game? Eh? Pack my luggage. I like to leave this place. Pack my luggage. I have come here for preaching. I am so foolish. Pack my luggage. I like to go away. Then he started packing his own luggage. In the meantime, information gone. Maharaj going away from this place. Then all running. This is the situation. Sannyasi means all the time 100%. You should know this criteria. All the 24 hours busy. Then that sannyasi can advise you. Otherwise he has no right to advise you, no right to go for preaching. But to speak. So this way I like to stop here. If you have any question, you can put. Vancha kalpa durusya kripa sindhu bhavishya pati tanang pavane pavishna vyo namo.
Maharaj. Thank you very much. You mentioned there's two duties.
Huh?
One duty is to do bhajan and the next one is mukunda seva. But how could you do bhajan if
many time I give answer in Bengali, in Hindi, many time, English also. Actually, those who like to put this question in front of me, Maharaj, those who are not going for preaching, how actually in Gauriya Math, it is the explanation of Prabhupad or Guru Bhargava. In Gauriya philosophy, preaching means also Hari Bhajan. Try to understand my point. Very vital. Don't try to misunderstand me. Otherwise you can mis-explain and speak. What I mean to say, realize. First of all, the thing you cannot realize, how you can impart. But you cannot realize yourself. How you can give? What for you are going for preaching? To give Krishna Prema, to distribute Krishna Prema. Whereas you yourself don't have Krishna Prema. Try to realize. That's why our Guru Bhargava is giving strong definition. Prabhupada, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Keshav Maharaj, Bhaman Maharaj, all speaking there. Same thing. One day, one disciple of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, long ago, maybe 40 years back, hey, maybe 25 years back, one day, one disciple, Sevak of Bhaman Maharaj and some of his associates speaking, Maharaj, from next time I am not going for preaching because in preaching we cannot do bhajan. Prachan is Ishra. Bhaman Maharaj laughing. What do you mean by preaching? What do you mean by preaching? What do you mean by bhajan? Prabhupada speaking, Keshav Maharaj speaking, that in Gauriya Darshan, preaching and Gauriya Bhajan all same. The day you can feel this thing, if you are not qualified to feel this thing, that my preaching is equal to bhajan. My preaching means bhajan. I have no self-interest. I never expect any pranami from you. I have no self-interest. Only I am coming to you to give something. What I got from my Guru Bhargava. If this kind of motto is there in my life, then I can come and sit in Vyasasan. Otherwise, I have no right to sit in Vyasasan. Follow what I say. So in Gauriya Darshan, in Gauriya philosophy, Gauriya Vichar, especially in Gauriya Mad, Hari Bhajan and preaching all the same. When I am speaking Harikatha, I touch Vyasasan speaking, I am doing topmost bhajan. When you are going to give me scope to speak Harikatha, then I pray Dandavat unto your lotus feet because you are giving me topmost chance to get in touch with Supreme Lord Hari Bhajan. When I go away, maybe I am thinking about Gomata, also it has some connection with Hari Seva. Some machine gone out of order, I will have to call somebody. But if I can connect all topics with Krishna Bhajan, then I am very clever. Jejan Krishna Bhaje Sehai Chotur. Those who are actually doing Krishna Bhajan, they are very shrewd, very clever. They know how to engage you in Hari Bhajan. They know how to cleverly engage you. You don't like to do Hari Bhajan. How to engage you in Hari Bhajan. They are very clever. That's why Prabhupada speaking, Krishna Bhakto Shaitan is Shaitan. Krishna Bhakto, one devotee of Krishna, is you know, Shaitan is Shaitan. You are very wicked. He is more clever than you. Can engage you in Hari Bhajan. Swami Maharaj used to engage you. All drunk. You do Harinam. I can cook for you. Swami Maharaj is sure. If they do Harinam, then shortly they can change. The same thing happened. His technique of preaching was totally different. Nobody could realize it. That's why so many problems arise. I can realize the heart of Swami Maharaj by His mercy. My birthplace is not long distant from here. Charu Maharaj, Swami Maharaj, all nearby. Subhag Maharaj, all nearby. Anyway, so any question more?
Sorry, she didn't finish the second part of the
question. Second part, let.
No.
You speak out. Is totally different topics.
That's why
I'm speaking. It's totally separate topics. I already discussed for long 2-3 years. Guru Tattva top different secrets. I already discussed what should be the qualification of Guru. What should be the qualification of a disciple? I already discussed so many times. If you want to give me order. I can again discuss someday. Again I can discuss. Some point, not all. Day by day I discuss about Guru Tattva, top. Follow. Brazil Krishnadas, he gone mad. He's speaking. Yes, Brazil Krishnadas speaking. Maharaj, I was supposed to go away. When I hear all Guru Tattva, after that I settle down. I was walking down street. He jumped from one car. Maharaj, Maharaj! What happens? Who? I see Krishna Das, paying dandavat in street, speaking this way. It's not my capacity. It's the mercy of Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Guru Varga Kesab Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, Sami Maharaj, all their blessing on me. I have no quality. So excuse me, Vanchakal Vadurvasi Kevasin Bhaji. I can discuss from this book also, sannyas. There is an English translation going on, I don't know when, because time is very limited. See, if I can get inspiration from you all, one kind of inspiration already coming from Guru Varga. Another kind of inspiration I can expect from you all. What is that inspiration? You are sincere. That is one kind of inspiration. If I don't find inspiration, not that, be sure I am going to stop Harikatha and do Hari Bhajan. There should not be any disturbance. You must be very careful. Lead your grihastha life also very scientific way. Otherwise, I can leave you all. Be careful.
That's just one short question. Huh? Sometimes you say, or often you say, that Siddhanta is same as Seva in applied form.
Huh?
Just speak a little bit more.
Siddhanta means, whenever I am hearing some Siddhanta from Guru Varga, or Guru Varga, maybe language is totally different. Language, or the way of representation is different. But the what he mean to say, Siddhar Goswami what mean to say, Bhaktivinoda Puri Goswami mean to say, same thing. But little language different, and way of representation is different. So you should get harmony. And another point, you can think very scientifically, Siddhanta we are thinking, but Siddhanta, when this Siddhanta not coming in my life in applied form, that Siddhanta is not out of my realization 100%. Any Siddhanta, Seva, Siddhanta means Seva and Siddhanta. I like to apply Siddhanta, mean I am going to do Seva. And Seva I like to represent in language, it can become Siddhanta. Follow. Very scientific. Vanchakalpatra Goswami.